Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to introduce to you a magnificent hotel in my hometown, which has a beautiful design. This place used to be an old house in the past, until the owner bought it and it was renovated into a hotel with modern equipment. This place has a two-floor restaurant with spacious rooms for special ceremonies. In the upper floor there is a spectacular building overlooking the courtyard. In the courtyard there is a pool with fountains which creates a tranquil vibe in every booth. This mansion has a special feature, which is in every part there are some ancient artifacts, just like a museum, that attracts visitors, and I will elaborate and show all of them down the line. Beside every booth there is a flower bed to create a serene mood for guests, not to mention that this place has a giant awning that is used during autumn and winter season. Each booth has cushions and colorful lights that create a beautiful place during nighttime. Chandeliers in covered parts are decorated with Ajar King's face, and ceilings have unique designs with triangular patterns. There are some niches which designated to hold an artifact. Many of them are clay or copper dishes and some paintings with festive themes which show the ceremonies in the past. Upper floor has a stone banister plus booths and halls for holding special ceremonies like birthdays or weddings. In the other part, we have rooms for reservation, which has a spectacular landscape. This part has some clay dishes around the courtyard, in addition to many flower pots that double down the beauty of this section. At both sides, there are rooms with distinguished design for guests. Trees, flowers, and pool create a welcoming place and calm mood for visitors. In the other side, we have a porch with clay dishes and flower pots overlooking the courtyard. There are octagonal places at both sides of this section. Each of them has symmetrical design with doors and a small pool in the middle of them, and some niches for showing ancient artifacts. This part has a basement replete with handicrafts, which I explain more about them down the line. In the upper floor, there are commodious rooms that are used for holding special ceremonies and designated to VIP visitors. Doors in this part have colorful windows and geometrical motifs that make this section compelling. This port has comfortable chairs and fascinating chandeliers. In Iranian architectural design, doors are symmetric and in odd numbers for making the room's structure more durable and double down the aesthetic aspect of this part. In basement we have tiles and handicrafts in every niches and the ceiling with distinguished architecture, plus a luxurious chandelier in the middle of it. If you ever decided to visit Kashan city, don't forget to come to this place and try its scrumptious foods. I personally suggest you try kebab. It's so delicious. In other parts of the basement, we have a section to exhibit the handicrafts. One of them is a colossal chalice made of copper, which has unique carvings that show celebrations by people in that time. Also, you can see some patterns look like trees and flowers on the external body of the chalice. Another artifact is a kitchen appliance which is used for boiling water, with its teapot for brewing tea. All of them made of copper to transfer the heat more easily. On the body of this artifact, there are some carvings too, which show celebrations, hunting, or romance scene. This place has a distinguished feature, which is contained so many colorful tiles with miscellaneous themes, scenes, and eminent persons. There is a tray with painting pertaining to the war and shows soldiers with uniforms. Copper dishes glazed with unique materials used as a tray with special carvings. In other corner we have a hammock that used as a bed for infants in the past. There is a transcription of a poem on the wall, and the pièce de résistance is a painting that shows a celebration and people with native clothes are dancing, eating, and playing instruments. Old lamp is hanging from the ceiling that used kerosene to light the environment. There is a clay dish served as a water storage, like a canteen, to preserve the water and keep it cool during summertime. Other clay dishes were used for keeping vinegar or pickles. These dishes glazed with unique materials to avoid the leakage of liquids inside the pot. In other part, there is an old chest for keeping clothes away from the moths. In the vestibule and entering hall, there are some tiles in rhombus shape, which have sophisticated paintings on them. Other tiles that show Hachamaneshi soldiers and Great Cyrus, who ruled over Iran 2,500 years ago. And finally, the collection of most famous and respected persons in Iran's history, that you can see their portraits on the tiles. And at the end of the entering hall, there is a cobblestone path in geometrical shape. For any reservation, you can visit their website, emaratemandegar.com. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Let me know your opinion in the comment section, and if you like, please subscribe to my channel and wait for new videos.